We are back. Welcome back, everybody. Oh gosh. Oh jeez. I'm sorry, SP. Oh boy. I'm sorry, honey. I have to rest the cable on top of her because she's sleeping or napping in the line of fire, I guess you could say. Let's see. Start. I don't know why it took so long. 29%. Wow, we're not as far back as I thought. I thought we were at like 20-something percent. So I guess that's exactly what I thought. But 29% is like exact. It's like closer to 30. I thought we were closer to 20. So, this will be a quicker stream, as is usual lately. By quicker, I mean like a couple hours, maybe. And also, I don't anticipate, like, progressing much. I don't anticipate progressing much. But we'll see. Like, I looked at the... I uploaded or exported some of the clips to YouTube. Or some of the streams. No, I exported all of the Cuphead streams to YouTube. And the last one in particular was very unproductive. It was like an hour long of just this level. And you'll have to forgive me. I have not played the game for a few days. So I'm going to be a little rusty. I do not like this guy at all. I'm happy he killed me. You know what? I like that he killed me. I'm happy with that. That's fine. Yeah, so we're going to have just a quicker stream today. I don't know why I'm doing those lately. Maybe my interests are changing or something. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. It's just I am... It's harder for me to set myself up for almost like 8 hours. Well, not. Only a couple of my streams have gone over the 7 hour mark. It's still something that I have a hard time doing for some reason, lately at least. But that's okay, you know? That's okay. Things change. I'm not leaving streaming anytime soon, if that's what you're worried about. That's absolutely not something to worry about. But I will say that I am not good at this game. That's for darn sure. Also, I was listening back. Oh, not a sin. Oh gosh. Wait, what the? Oh, okay. So it follows two heads. Two heads. How is that even a thing, though? Okay. Why? Why, everybody? Yeah, the first try. Sorry. That was close. I don't like when she throws her head at you. I do not like that. It's a very difficult thing to, like, avoid. Okay, well, we did that. Good. Nice! We unlocked a new area, it looks like. Baroness von Bonbon. Yos. I listened back to some of the clips that I put on YouTube. Because, like, when I clip them out of the broadcast and make a highlight of it and then export it, whoa. This is interesting. Okay, can we not, though? It's... Anyways, yeah, okay, so there are moments where I am able to listen to the, oh, come on, doll brawl. Oh, does this not hurt me? Oh, okay, good. Then I will continue to not, okay, I'm sure the spinny thing hurts you. But I doubt the cane does. Whoa, he's golden. He's a golden god. What is going on? Oh, come on. I was trying to look at the pattern. Oh, dang. So I learned a couple interesting things when I was listening to myself. I learned that I apparently... I claim that this is a family-friendly stream, and that's, you know, it's started as a joke, but I have been trying to move more towards it. But I noticed that I mostly have issues saying swear words on stream. That's what I've been trying to fix, but what I have not been trying to fix is the actual, like, content of the stuff I'm talking about. So a good example is taking our favorite artistic exhibitionists and discussing how much we love all of them. That is something that is decidedly not as family-friendly or appropriate as some people like myself might lead you to believe. Will I stop doing that stuff? Probably not. I think... Does this hurt me? Oh, nice. It doesn't. Oh, it's a kitty. I don't want to hurt the kitty. Oh, gosh. The kitty. Whoa. What is all this? Will I stop talking about artistic exhibitionists? No, probably not. I think mostly I'm just going to try and not swear as much. And I think in that department, I've been doing pretty well. I think last stream... I accidentally said a word or two, but that's pretty incredible compared to, I don't know, if you were an OG streaming fan of mine, you should know that that's, me not swearing in a stream is actually pretty incredible. Like, even swearing just once in the span of an hour is pretty incredible. So, yeah, there you go. That's what I'm trying to say, is I'm probably not going to put... I'm probably not going to put a stop to the content of what I talk about. Especially because, for the most part, I try and... Like, I want this to be sort of an educational venue, which nobody really likes. Except a very... one person, which is me. And that's okay, you know, whatever. But I try to, like, if I'm talking about something, I'm gonna try and use the more scientific terminology or euphemisms rather than explicit. Like artistic exhibitionist instead of the alternative, which is you know, the alternative. So that's where I am at. I just wanted to let you know that I am aware that I talk about some iffy things still, but I don't think that should detract from how well I'm doing with not swearing. I think the swearing is pretty incredible. How much I'm not doing it, basically. No! Alright. So what's on the docket for playing streams and stuff? Like, what am I going to try and stream? Who the heck knows? That's a great question. I kind of just stream what I'm enjoying at the time. Or in the case of Monster Hunter Online and Phantasy Star 2, Phantasy Star Online 2, certainly not Phantasy Star 2. I would hate that game, and I would never stream it. But now that I said that, I kind of want to stream it to be ironic, you know? You know how that goes? Like you make a joke about, oh, that would be so stupid, and then you do it because it's kind of ironic and funny in a way. But then you realize, oh wait, it's not really a joke anymore, is it? It's like you're really invested. Anyways, in the case of those games, those types of games, those were more like I figured we could get some fun verbiage, some fun commentary. Not necessarily fun games. Now, okay, you might be thinking that means I'm saying I only played those games to stream them or something, but that's not the case at all, dude. That is absolutely not the case. If I know I'm not gonna like a game, I'm not gonna be streaming it. Like, at all. That's a fact. If I'm trying out a game, I will stream it. If I end up not liking that game, then there's a good chance you won't see me streaming it a second time. And by extension, a third or fourth time. And that's basically where Phantasy Star Online 2 and Monster Hunter Online rest. They rest in purgatory, in the sense that I'm never going to touch them again. Not on stream, probably not ever. I don't know. I'm not. Monster Hunter Online, I can understand me not liking, because the gameplay was terrible. Phantasy Star Online 2, that one bothered me. Because I really, really love Monster Hunter Online. I mean, Phantasy Star Online's Episode 1 and 2. Really love those. What if you don't think you like a game, but then you actually like it? Well, that's where Monster Hunter Online. No. I don't have a good example for that happening, but if I get a game and I think I'm gonna hate it and then I start enjoying it, then of course I'll start playing it more. Also, welcome, Bieber. Yeah, I don't have any problem with that at all. It happens a lot, actually. Not just with video games, like in real life. I think that, like, I hated Twilight for the longest time. This is where I'm gonna lose basically all of my followers. I hated Twilight for the longest time, and then suddenly, I didn't anymore. It's actually a funny story. I might have told it on stream already. That's a worry for me about these streams, is I'm gonna tell a lot of stories multiple times, I think. Because I don't know who I've talked to. Like, I don't know who I've told the stories to or who was watching at the time. Anyways, so around the time when Twilight first came out, I was like, oh my god, stupidest thing ever. People need to shut up about it. Why is it so popular? It's so stupid. The books are terrible. And of course, at this time, I had never actually touched one of the books. I just assumed they were bad because everyone else said they were bad. Everyone in my circle of friends. But okay, so I hated it until New Moon came out on DVD. When New Moon came out in theaters, my mom, when she saw the trailer, she was like, "Paul, do you think that looks good?" I mean, not Paul. I'm not Paul. Slim Shady. "Slim Shady, do you think that looks good?" And I was like, "No. It looks like trash." And then she saw it and she called me afterwards and she's like, "Paul, Slim Shady, you're totally right. That movie was so horrible." And I was like, "I told you." And she's like, "How do you know these things?" And I'm like, "I just do." So then here's the funny thing. The movie comes out on DVD and I call my mom. I'm like, "Hey, is there, like, okay, I know you hated New Moon, but is it funny? Like, is it a bad like a funny kind of bad, or is it just sad bad? And she said, you know, I think you're going to love it because it's so horrible. And I was like, okay, cool. So I picked it up, and I watched it. And this is where everything changed. I was watching it, and it was like probably 10:30, 11 p.m. at night. I was watching it, and I was like, uh-oh. Like, the movie starts, and I'm immediately hooked. And I'm, like, scratching my head, like, uh-oh. What's going on here? This isn't good. This is not a good sign. And then the music starts playing, and I'm like, oh, no. Because when good music is in a movie, I tend to overlook a lot of the faults of the rest of the movie. The music in New Moon still is absolutely fantastic. So I'm watching it, and I'm like, ugh, God, this is not good. Like, this is really, really bad. Not the movie, but the fact that I was actually loving it. I mean, I was loving it. And then I finished the movie, and it's like 12 in the morning or something, and I'm like, okay, you know what? Maybe it's just I'm tired. You know, I'm pretty tired. I'm not thinking straight. Let's watch it in the morning when I'm all rested. So I watch it in the morning. I wake up. I'm like, oh, thank God. Okay, it was just a funny fluke. I hate that movie. Why would I like it? I wake up. I start watching it again. And I fall in love with it a second time. And I'm like, oh, crap. Like, this is not good. So, cue my obsession with Twilight. I loved it so much that I actually became obsessed with Twilight, the series, and I was obsessed with it for quite a long time, actually, until the last movie came out. And then after that, it still persisted quite a while. So, basically, what I'm trying to say is, I'm not... Like, I might initially not like something for some stupid reason. And I admit, I was not liking Twilight. Or I wasn't disliking Twilight for the right reasons. I was doing it just because everyone else hated it. But what I'm trying to say is that I still admitted defeat. I admitted that it was a great series to myself. I know that... Objectively speaking, they're not the best made movies. Okay, the first movie, by all accounts and measures, is not good. But I love it. And that's kind of an after school special type of moment. You shouldn't feel bad for liking something. And if you end up loving something that you originally hated, no matter what the reasons were for hating it, don't like feel bad. You know, just do you. You know? Do you, boo. The game Da Vinci Code on PS2, IGN gave it like a 4.8, I think. And I love it. I still played it. I played it recently. Like a year ago, I think. It was so good. I love it. I don't know why it got such bad reviews. And that's the sort of thing... I don't know. I don't know what I'm getting at. Basically, if I think I'm not going to like it, but I end up liking it, good. I'm excited about that. I don't like not liking things. Aside from the initial, like, you know, rants about how bad it is or whatever, I don't really enjoy not liking things. You might think I do. You might think I revel in the hatred, but I don't. I much prefer enjoying things that I spend my time with. The same thing happened with 50 Shades, too. Funny enough, because it's 50 Shades was fanfic. It started as a fanfiction of Twilight. I don't know what it is, but yeah, I same kind of deal. I was like, that book sounds so stupid. It's for old ladies to get their ovaries off or whatever. And then I loved it. I loved it a lot. I really, I don't know if I can say objectively those books have a lot more meaning than people give them credit for, but subjectively, I got way more out of the 50 Shades books than a lot of people seem to give it credit for. Like, I kind of liked them on a personal level, too. Like, I kind of saw myself in both the characters. And what I love the most about it is that Anastasia Steele is, like, based on the title, it's 50 Shades of Grey. And I was wondering while I was reading it, like, why is it called that? And then suddenly, I was like, oh, crap. Like, Anastasia Steele is kind of like, it's kind of a yin and yang dynamic. Okay, Anastasia Steele is the white part of the yin and the yang. Or, I think it's the yin. One of them's the white part, one of them's the black part. But basically, Christian Grey is, yes, that's why it's called 50 Shades of Grey, because his last name is Grey. Okay, we know that. But I think if you look deeper into it, it's more of a yin and yang situation, where it's like this woman, Anastasia Steele, she's very pure, sort of. She hasn't explored herself in a lot of ways, and she's very pure and innocent in a way, very light. And then Christian Grey comes along, and he's very dark. And he's kind of attracting her with his darkness. But the thing is, like, she still has a little bit of darkness inside of her that makes her able to say, okay, you know what, I want to give this a shot. So then the Anastasia Steele-Christian Grey relationship happens, and it's like an ever-changing kind of dynamic where she's the... like, she's the left part of the yin-yang, he's the right, and no longer is he all dark, and no longer is she all light. It's now she... it's kind of, they're both an amalgamation of one another. And I love that. I love that so much. I love the whole black and white thing. I love it. It's so good. And, spoilers, I think the metaphor is completely justified, because what better manifestation of the amalgamation of a relationship and all of its, you know, goods and bads, what better way to manifest that than with a baby? And that's really like the 50 Shades of Grey. It's black and white mixing and swirling into gray. And I love that so much. And yes, I am looking so deep into it, you might think that I wrote it or something, or I'm being paid to promote it. I'm not. But I am in love with it. 50 Shades Darker, was not a huge fan of the movie. It is my favorite book from that series. My favorite book of all time is Moby Dick. But my favorite book in the 50 Shades series is 50 Shades Darker. I just thought that the introspection on Christian Grey and his psychology was really good. That was the best part of that book for me. But it's, I don't know, it's really everything. 50 Shades of Grey was kind of her discovering him, and then discovering each other. 50 Shades Darker was kind of her exploring him, and he's exploring her as well. And then 50 Shades Freed is like, it's the finale. No. I mean, I've never tried it, but I don't think so. I mean, I understand the point of kinkiness, I think. I can understand that, but I'm not really... I don't know. I'm not really into that, no. But I also haven't had much of an avenue to try that, so I don't know. Like, it might be the same thing as Twilight and 50 Shades. I might really dislike it right now, and then I'm going to be obsessed with it later. I don't know. This boss is making me sad. Oh no. No. Oh my gosh.
Oh man, that was spooky!
It's so much better. That's good to know. Thank you. Also, I don't know what you mean by when you accidentally have a boy cereal. That's kind of bothering me. I don't know what you mean by that. Oh god, I didn't even see that. That beating was for free, no strings attached. That's funny, because he's a marionette. Or a puppet. No, that's a marionette. I mean, it's a puppet. A marionette's a puppet, I guess. So it's both. I think. Oh, you do move faster, dude. You absolutely move faster when you're tiny. Oh yeah, if you're just joining us, I'm not anticipating making too much progress. I mean, we already beat the level that we were stuck on last time, but... It's like when you go look at cereal, but you get the cereal with nuts. I don't really... I don't like nuts in my cereal. Like, Smart Start, they're not nuts. They're like nut clusters, I think. Something about the texture hurts my teeth. So I'm not sure I enjoy that. At all, to be honest. I much prefer, like, With the nut clusters, they don't soften up with the milk, or the almond milk. I don't know if it changes with regular milk. I doubt it. But the nut clusters do not soften up with it. Whereas the flakes, the Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Frosted Flakes, Wheaties, all that stuff softens up with the milk. Okay, we're just gonna retry. If he ever starts with that phase, because that phase I have consistently lost. I'm sorry. I guess I'm giving up a little there, but I can't stand that phase, and I really like kitties. So this phase is a little better, but not great. My wife. Cookie Crisp. No, Cookie Crisp kind of softens up with the milk. I don't know. I just don't like... for some reason, it hurts my teeth. And by extension, my head. When I bite into something really soft, but then something really hard at the same time. It also screws with my worldview. Oh my god! I need to stop standing right there, because that is not a good place, though. You know what? We're actually gonna, we're gonna try and go through this whole phase without doing the big ol' thingy. And then we're gonna use the big ol' thingy on the marionette douche. Dude, I meant dude. Where do we stand on douche? Is that family friendly or nah? I feel like I might have just screwed myself on that one. Okay. Oh god, those do hurt you. Oh my gosh. How do you not die to that? I like big old thingies. This will get red hot. It's on. douche is not family friendly. How do you explain what that is to a child? Well, from a sexual education standpoint, it's not bad. It's just, I mean, it's the same thing as trying to explain what a tampon is. Except the douche is not, a douche is not, recommended. In fact, I believe it's strongly recommended against using a douche, because it throws off the delicate pH balance of the vagina. So it's not as, like, ubiquitous as a tampon, but I feel like it could happen in the same conversation. So if you're old enough to learn about tampons, you're old enough to learn about douches. In fact, it's better to learn as young as possible about douches. Well, okay, let's not go that far. But it's better to be safe than sorry. I think, I don't even know why they still sell douches. Like, I think they're supposed to be extremely deleterious to the health of the vagina. And I don't understand why that can still be sold. Well, okay, I guess cigarettes can still be sold. Am I saying that douches are as dangerous to the human body as cigarettes? Yeah, I mean, I guess you could say that, yeah. But I'm not, I don't actually think that. I do think that douches should not be, I don't actually know where they are in the stores, but I don't know where they are in the stores. I'm assuming they're in the feminine hygiene aisle. I feel like something that's that, not harmful, deleterious is the better word than harmful. If it's that deleterious to the female genitalia, I just don't think it should be sold in such an easy fashion. I don't know. That's weird. That's an interesting, I mean, maybe they have stopped selling them, but last I heard, they had not. And that, to me, is a little concerning. Especially for women who have not educated themselves on that whole thing. Because I think there are women that think it is more beneficial. And I think maybe some, perhaps women working in the informal economy, consider it much more beneficial to maintaining a good physical image or something for their clients. I don't know. That's tricky. That's really tricky. Let's do it! Oh no! Oh no. Okay. Alright. No! Wow! The buffer time on those shots was insane! Lee fast. Like, it's not insane as in a good thing. Like, that was a bad buffer time. I don't like this one, this phase either, but it's better than the kitty phase. Oh no, it's better than the kitty variant. I mean, maybe you can use that there. I don't think so. What would the purpose be? I think that's where an enema comes in handy. I don't think so. God, it happened again almost. Oh, yep. Oh, jeez. Okay. Oh, yep. Oh man, that was scary. Isn't an enema just a... Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like... Why would you use the douche when you have an enema? That's the whole... That's what I was trying to... That was the message I was trying to get across. It's a bit redundant. Or not even redundant, just unnecessary. Is maybe the better word. I actually don't know. Okay. How do we do this? Oh, his hands don't hurt you. Oh, that makes it a little easier. Now let's see what kind of... Oh, Jesus! Before I was so rudely interrupted, I was going to say, let's see how... Crazy. Let's see what kind of crazy stuff comes out of this one or something. Like, what kind of crazy attacks come out of this phase? Gotta be honest, the kitty phase is not that bad. I don't know what I was thinking. I was going crazy, apparently. Can you hurt yourself up there? No. Okay, good, good, good. I think you do hurt yourself if you... Oh, God! There you go. If you hit the totems. Or whatever they are. I'm a little... I'm American, so I don't know what these are in the context of Egypt, but, I don't think Egypt has totem poles. That's like a... Or no, am I thinking of tikis? No! No way! Egypt does not have totem poles, dude. That's like a Hawaii thing and, like, South America and all that stuff. That's like everything but Egypt, dude. Obviously. Okay, let's get little Mr. Soldier Boy. You know, I kind of want to save... I feel like I could do this phase. Oh god, don't do it, bro. You know, I don't want to... I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to... Let's do that. Okay. Oh my god! No, stop it! Stop it! Okay. Jeez. Oh, gosh. Okay, okay. Here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. Okay, okay. How? What is this crap? Okay. I take it back. Maybe it would behoove us to engage in utilizing our ultimate power on that phase, rather than Puppet Man. I think that's it. God, the background is freaking me out, dude. It's so beautifully done, too. I love it. Everything about this game is beautiful. It's just... I don't know. Actually... Oh God. That was the worst one yet, I think, honestly. No, wait, no, I think on the cat phase I've died a couple times, so... Never mind. But the cat phase is not that bad, though. Okay, now that's pretty bad. Don't worry about it, though. We got this. I don't remember... Oh, there we go. Okay, here we go, here we go. We're gonna parry this. Parry! Parry! Oh, crap. Oh, yeah. I was wondering why he kept sending them out. I think it's because I was not shooting... I was focusing on dodging and parrying.
Oh boy.
We got a dodo. Yeah, we got a dodo. We better than we ever been before.
That's my sound effect for that guy. Oh my gosh. Okay, we can. There we go. Okay.
Okay, come on, 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 come on. Yes! Hey, I'm playing Cuphead right now, too! I know! I mean, well, I didn't know that you were doing it right now, but I saw that you were playing it earlier. I saw that you got it, and I'm so excited! I hope you enjoy it. I mean, I hope you're enjoying it. Like, how far are you? What do you think? Tell me all about it, dog. Also, I hope I haven't spoiled you. Oh, wait, you talked to me about that. You said you're pretty much, like, you spoiled the whole game or something. Oh, my God. This game is stupid. I hate it. It's the worst game ever. Further than you right now, I'm on the third island? What the heck, dude? That's stupid. You suck at the game is what you're telling me, then. No! Oh, that's so close, dude. You're on the third island. How? You've only played for like... God. You've only played for like 5 hours or something. Or 4 hours last I checked. And you were away for most of that. So I'm assuming it's only like 2 hours. How did you get like so far? I feel so inadequate now. IDK, I'm good at the game? Wow, Curb. There's a thing in this world called modesty. I think you should look up what it is. I'm, like, half joking, but not really. She used the Y button more in the flying one. Well, I know that that's there, but I haven't found much reason to use it in this level. Because I know you move faster, but... I don't know. Oh, come on, bro. Okay. I need to work on Soulja Boy, I think. Or not. I don't know, actually. I don't know. Oh, my God. Yeah, we should have done it on Soulja Boy. I guess... I don't know. So far, I have not found too much of a reason to use the Y button move. Except, like, never. Oh, you know what? It would have worked well there, because my speed was too slow. I don't use bombs because I want to save up for the super move. So that I can, like, demolish the final phase. With, like... So I don't have to worry about the final phase as much. That's why. I mean, I don't use bombs because I'm not a baby... Baby. I'm not a baby. Oh, come on, though. Switch weapons? Switch weapons. What are you... Well, okay. Wait. I don't think I can... I don't think I have any other weapons yet. I mean, I'm not sure, but... Like, isn't it like you press left trigger or right trigger? Oh my God, this guy. This
It's ruining my zen-like state. Just kidding. Okay, I'm at the map. Oh my god. Okay. I'll get on Discord as long as you don't mind being on stream.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey, okay, so you see that guy, like northwest of your character that kind of looks like a bullet?
Yeah, like is he in front of the red thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, go click on him. He'll give you bombs for your plane.
What?
Like a secondary weapon, yeah. Just go click on him.
No way.
Uh-huh.
I doubt it's going to make it much easier, but that's still...
No, it is. It's for a specific part of that. No, go back and fight the same guy.
Okay.
I'll tell you when to use it, okay?
Okay. Switch weapon, left bumper, okay.
I'm shit, so there's delay.
There is a delay.
So start off using regular on this. Use the Y button to fly away from shit so you don't run into it. Like, it's just faster that way.
Yeah, I realized that. Thank you. When I almost died, or got hit by the swirly... Oh, God! I itched my nose. I almost ran into the thingy, so...
Yeah, so use a regular for this part. Whenever it switches stages and it turns into those pillars... What you want to do is hit it a couple times with your normal attack and then switch over to the bomb and blow them up. And then do that. Make sure you get all the faces, even whenever there's two faces on one pillar. Try to do that to every single one. It does more damage to the boss that way.
Really?
Yeah. This game's weird. You can do damage to the like next phase of the boss before the phase is over. So basically, you just want to hit it like a couple times with the normal Gatling gun and then blow it up with a bomb.
Hmm. Interesting. Well, thank you very much for those tips.
Yeah, and then you want to use the bomb in the sarcophagus part. If you just stay up near the top, it's really easy to dodge most of the stuff.
I don't know what's happened. It's like since we started talking, I have now lost...
All your skill.
All skill that wasn't even there before, but it's definitely not there now.
I mean, don't worry about it. I'm gonna go a little brawl real quick. I'll be right back.
Okay. Oh god. Okay. Oh, bold freak. Oh my god. This game is stupid. Okay. Oh god, no, no, why you hate me, bro? Oh crap. Are you serious? Holy crap, that was so fast! That was so much faster, bro. Oh, you slut! Okay.
Alright, hello?
Hey, what's up, brother? Bruv?
Hey, so have you started to learn the merits of the bomb a little bit?
I mean, a little, yeah. I mean, I can see it's very powerful. I beat the sarcophagus boss in, like, less time, for sure.
Yeah, okay, so the strats that I'm telling you are, like, stuff that I've seen from a speedrunner.
Yeah! I'm doing speedrun strats! Sorry, was there more to that statement?
No.
Oh, good.
Didn't think there was. It's just, like, they usually have the best strats for beating bosses in games like this.
And are your bombs limited or unlimited?
No, they're unlimited, just like that regular Gatling shot.
Ah, you slut! Okay. Oh my god, I hate this game, dude. Aww, the poor sarcophagus is crying. I hate that so much. Does blowing bombs on the guy before he turns into Puppet Man do anything?
I would use your, like, super thing on the puppet.
Yeah, I just did. Because I'm good at this game.
And make sure to parry the pink ones. And charge your super up more for the next phase.
What does the parry do exactly? Like, does it give...
It charges your super.
Oh, that's... Sorry.